Hey guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Jerrica, and I just kind of want to do a video on self-confidence because I know it's something that a lot of women struggle with, young, old, middle-aged, or whatever you want to call it. And I even struggle with self-confidence. So I just want to do a video on ways that, you know, you can try and boost your self-confidence and feel better about yourself. So if you would like to see what that is, then keep watching. So about self-confidence, growing up I was never really confident in myself, or how I looked, and I used to be so skinny, like so stick skinny. I'll put a picture right here. Yeah, I was super skinny, and therefore I didn't like the way I looked in jeans. Like, I had no shape whatsoever. I was just, my arms were so skinny, and my thighs were skinny, and I was only 120 pounds, so it doesn't, I mean, it's not like it's 100 pounds, so it wasn't just, you know, dying skinny, but I was just like, I was not happy with myself. I was always subconscious, wondering what are other people thinking, what do people think about me, what do they think I look like. I mean, I just always thought about that, and I just never felt confident, and, okay, so our electric is flashing, but anyway, I just never felt confident enough, and 24 years old now. I'm actually 150 pounds now. I don't know if you can tell, but yeah. I mean, I hold it pretty well. I put a video right here. I mean, a picture right here. But yeah, and I still struggle with self-confidence. Like, I really, it's a battle for me. It really is. It always has been. It's not as bad as it used to be, but it is a battle. Like, there's some days where I just don't even want to get out of bed because I'm just like, I don't like the way I look. And I don't know why that is. I just really struggle with self-confidence. So I'm like, you know what? Why keep talking to myself in such a negative way? Why keep saying, oh, you look fat. Oh, well, your hair looks bad today. Ooh, your eyebrows are ugly. The list goes on. But I think the best way to start loving who you are is to just look at your flaws, point them out, just accept them for what they are because they're you. They're your specific genes. That's how God made you, and He already made us perfect, and His eyes were perfect anyway. So, I mean, just to name a few, my eyebrows. I don't like my eyebrows. I never have. I know I got them plucked a few years ago. I think it was right after I got married or whatever, and they've just never grown back the same. But before I discovered filling in my brows, I was just like, oh my God. Still struggle with my eyebrows. One is higher than the other naturally. As you can see, one is, I mean, I don't know why that is, but I've just learned to embrace it because it's just part of who I am and there's nothing I can do about it. And I just look at my stomach and I'm just like, oh my God, something needs to be done. Like, I'm not saying this as in, because no one is perfect. And there's people out there that you look at and you're like, oh my God, they are so pretty. I don't know what they're talking about. And I see some people that say they struggle with self-confidence, and I'm just like, how? You're perfect. Like, but then I'm like, okay. I totally see where they're coming from because I feel the same way all the time. And like I said, I have to keep telling myself that I am beautiful. And I have to feel good about myself. Like, sometimes you have to make yourself feel good. You gotta fake it till you make it type thing. So, if there's anyone out there that struggles with self-confidence, learn to love who you are. If you have flaws, accept them. The sooner you accept them, the sooner you can move on and start to embrace it. Because like I said, you are who you are. And you know, nowadays they have plastic surgery and everything else. I feel like they just lose you completely. I don't think anyone should do plastic surgery unless it's for like medical reasons. For example, my ear. It's another thing I'm self-conscious about. My ear split. I mean, the initial split came when I fell asleep and woke up. My earrings were stuck in the sheets, and I didn't know it. And I got up and pulled it. Ever since then, my earlobe has just been really. But then, back in November last year, one morning I just woke up and I'm like, whoa, this is extreme. I'm really subconscious about that. Sometimes I'm just like, you know, I don't even want to wear my hair back. heck I'll wear my hair up ponytail because I don't want my ears show. But at the end of the day, I'm like, you know what? Please, my nose. I mean, I can't get it sewn up unless I find a plastic surgeon. So I just have to get used to it or just, you know, just embrace it. And then if someone makes fun of me for it, then they're just an idiot. That's how I feel, because it's just what it is. And like, Lewis can go on with my flaws and how I feel about myself. But like I said, you just gotta just stop thinking negatively about yourself. The sooner you stop, the better. Because when you constantly talk to yourself, saying these social media things, then it just makes things 10 times worse. And next thing you know, you're just like, oh, I don't want to live anymore. And that's just not a good place to be. So, you know, write out what you love about yourself. A piece of paper, write, like, what do I love about myself? Write out your flaws and just learn to love and embrace each one of your flaws, because the sooner you do that, like I said, the better. Just do this every day. Tell yourself every day what it is that you love about yourself. Look yourself in the mirror and say, I am beautiful. Just say a bunch of I ams and say it repeatedly, because the more you say it, the more in your subconscious is going to go, and one day you're gonna wake up and you're like, wow. Your brain, you actually start to believe it, and you'll start to feel confident. It'll just exude through to who you are, and it works. I'm telling you, it works. Like I said, I'm not 100% perfect with how I feel about myself, but I'm getting there. And I just wanted to make this video for anybody else that may be feeling down, whether you're in high school, elementary, because these days, with the examples that we have on TV, we all want butt injections, boob plant implants, lip jobs, nose jobs, and I just think that is so stupid. I would never get butt injections, I would never get implants on boobs, like, no. If you want bigger butt, just eat more. No point in getting butt injections, I mean, they don't look natural at all. But anyway, that's another story. So, I really hope this video helps somebody out there that may be struggling with self-confidence. Make sure you leave a comment below. I would love to talk to anybody that may feel some type of way about themselves. Just please, if there's anyone out there that can help change your viewpoint on themselves, please leave a comment below.